government officials insist that this is an isolated incident. We will continue to keep you informed as this story unfolds.
Who's seen this movie? It's not exactly underground, but it came out, what, like 27 years ago now? And I don't think it was a huge blockbuster at the time. It's always been a movie that I really loved. An average man pushed to the breaking point by the mundane frustrations of the world. But I gotta be real clear here, as I know some people like to take things the wrong way. Bill, the main character in this film, is a horrible psychopath. He's the bad guy. Now, this should be painfully obvious to anyone watching the film, but there are moments in the movie that the wrong kind of person with the wrong kind of ideology could look at as a glorification of terrible views and actions. But with this diorama, I am honoring the film, not glorifying the character. I'm making this as a tribute to a villain, not a hero. It had actually been many years since watching the movie when I built this. I thought about watching it before starting, but instead decided to go off of memory and the iconic cover scene alone. I spent a fair bit of time trying to get the little set of concrete steps just right. This was harder than I anticipated, as they're kind of a weird design, and it's sort of hard to get a gauge on their bizarre layout from the cover photo. I was also eyeballing the scale without any reference, as the Bill model was quietly printing in the background while I built the base. This diorama wouldn't have a lot going on aside from the Bill character and the steps, so it was pretty important to get those steps looking right. And throughout the course of making the base, I actually modified them over and over and over again until I finally got them looking close to the cover scene photo. It's kind of funny because I first made the steps with the hot wire cutter, but by the end of it all and all the revisions, I'm pretty sure the finished steps were cut entirely with a knife. I've struggled a fair bit in the past getting little base edges to look right, but this time around I didn't run into any major issues, and I think I'm finally getting a good grasp on how to tackle this seemingly simple task that carries so much importance for the finished piece. In the time it took me to assemble the base, the Bill Mini was able to be printed start to finish on my resin printer. I'm sure some of you are wondering how I managed to find such a perfect Bill model to print. Well, that was thanks to the sponsor of this episode. Colossal Miniatures provides high-quality, 3D printer-friendly miniatures for RPGs, tabletop gamers, and collectors. They make their models available through a monthly Patreon service that costs only 10 bucks a month. When you join up, you will instantly get access to a massive welcome pack containing 40 minis. After that, you will get access to the monthly release of themed miniatures. What's cool about this company is that their service provides both classic fantasy RPG themed minis geared towards games like Dungeons and Dragons, as well as things like their Modern Day Survivors, which is a running themed set of modern characters based on classic movies. These modern survivors are the reason I wanted to work with this company. As soon as I saw that they had a Bill model of all people, I knew I had to make something with it. But at the same time, I was torn because they also had a bunch of these other iconic characters that I also wanted to work with. But in the end, I could only pick one. They even have this cool loyalty program that gives customers bonus zombified versions of these models after they've been a member for 3 months. I'll put a link in the video description if you want to check them out for yourself. Thanks, Colossal Miniatures, for sponsoring this build, but more importantly, thanks for creating this awesome miniature. Because building the scenic base didn't take very long, I was able to get into painting the mini with a comfortable amount of time left to work. I've been really guilty of rushing a lot of paint jobs in the past, and I often find myself disinterested in the painting portion of the hobby. But over the past few months, I've started to increase my skill level, and this has made me cross a sort of threshold where my ability now allows me to enjoy the process a bit more, and has given me the opportunity to actually develop my skills and techniques. I wanted to do a paint job on Bill that I'd be really proud of. So I took the time to really consider the right color palette. His white shirt and black pants were pretty limiting, but I used this as motivation to try to do those materials really well. I even decided to avoid using washes entirely. I wanted to force myself to use some precision and to work on better layering and blending techniques. So I didn't rush. I really took my time to calmly and methodically build up all the shadows and highlights on things like his shirt, pants, and skin. I was even feeling relaxed and confident enough to freehand on the stripes on his tie, despite my hand tremor. For me, pulling this off was a huge victory. I was also feeling confident enough to try some simple non-metallic metals on the gun and briefcase edges. This is completely out of character for me to not just reach for a bottle of metallic paint, and I honestly couldn't be happier with my choice to try this method instead for once. I also carefully painted in several different colors for his hair, trying to get somewhat realistic highlights as well as some subtle gray strands. I did make one error in judgment though. His glasses. Glasses are tricky on miniatures. This model was designed in a really nice way without solid lenses, which is pretty impressive that they actually printed out like that. I should have just left them that way, but I had this idea to fill them with clear resin to look like glass. But this was a total mistake. It really did look bad. And I ended up just painting over the resin. In the end, his glasses ended up being solid and looked more like goggles, which is unfortunate. It's my one regret. I should have just left the model the way the designers intended. Despite that one flub, I was overall really happy with how he was looking, and it inspired me to continue refining the details. All of those comments from anonymous people on the internet every day telling me that I'm a terrible painter washed away. You know what? Those people are wrong. I can paint well as long as I don't get too lazy or too rushed. And reminding myself of this is important because it's easy to feel like you might as well rush something because you think you're bad at it. Take the time. Remind yourself that you can do this and you'll be happier for it. Small details make the diorama. This was mostly an empty scene, but it had a few key elements. One is some bits of rebar sticking up and out of the stairs. I used some push pins for the larger rebar and a tiny bit of window screen for the smaller stuff on the side. But the most important detail is the iconic can of Coke sitting on the steps. I actually used a tiny bit of toothpick that I embedded into the foam for this. I just left enough protruding to create the cylinder of the can. And rather than just painting the concrete out a simple gray and doing a quick dry brush and a wash, I played around a little bit blending in some different warmer tones to kind of mimic the way the sunlight was hitting the steps in the photo. And that brought me to a crucial part of painting the base, and that's of course the graffiti. These steps in the movie are heavily covered and spray painted in tags and whatnot, and I did my best to portray that same sort of look with just a brush and paint. Then a little bit of red, white, and a touch of bright silver finished off the can of Coke. I needed a way to mimic the grass and dirt, so I turned to my supply of base-ready mixes from my buddy Luke at Geek Gaming, and I pulled out some grass tufts and clump foliage from my collection. I used a tiny bit of long reed-type grass to create the exact little tuft that you see in the photo on the side of the steps, and added in a few grass tufts across the base. In the photo, there's some trees or bushes off in the distance. Now, my base obviously doesn't extend far enough to do that, but to capture that same look and feel, I decided to just put one large bush in the back corner. This is such a fun part of the process, and it really brings things to life. One of these days, I will get around to getting a static grass applicator. I think that would have made it just that much better if I had used a proper applicator rather than simply sprinkling on some static grass. But all things considered, the grass did turn out pretty great on this piece. The most exciting point of any diorama build is placing the finished and painted model in the scene. One slight problem though, you might not be able to see it, but one of the shoes, one of his feet there, the toe is actually broken off. This must have broken when I removed the supports, and I didn't notice until midway through painting. To hide this, I came up with a simple solution of having a tiny piece of paper garbage blowing onto his foot. This doesn't just cover up the problem though, it's actually really in theme with the build and the movie. In the movie, the reason Bill actually sits down on these steps is to fix a hole in the bottom of his shoe with a bit of folded up newspaper. So fixing the model's broken shoe with a bit of paper has a bit of poetic beauty to it, or at least I think so. This inspired me to add some more little bits of garbage using tiny bits of paper, foil, and plastic. I think this might be my favorite diorama that I've made yet. It's definitely the miniature that I'm most proud of painting. It felt really good to paint him too. It was a liberating experience in a way to finally do a mini using more advanced techniques than just a wash and a highlight. I don't think I've ever painted a mini without using a wash at all before. What do you guys think? I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit the like button and let me know in the comments section. Maybe this will inspire you to do your own little diorama of an old favorite and maybe forgotten movie. Like I said earlier, Colossal Miniatures, they have a whole bunch of iconic characters for you to use. If you want to grab some hobby supplies for yourself and support the channel in the process, be sure to check out blackmagiccraft.ca. There I have an essential equipment page where I explain the stuff that I use most often, and buying through that page helps fund the production of videos like this. If you want to help out the channel in an even bigger way though, you can do so by joining the Black Magic Craft Fellowship on Patreon. Joining there gets you into the private Facebook group, Discord server, as well as lets you see the videos a little bit early. And that support is the main reason that I'm able to make weekly hobby videos. So thanks to everyone who supports me there. Thanks for watching everyone, and remember folks, Bill, he's the bad guy.